మనుస్మరంత రాత్రౌ చ కృష్ణం పునరుత్థితాయ తే కృష్ణ దేహ ప్రవిశంతి కృష్ణం ఆజ్యం యథా మంత్రహుతం హుతాశీ బుద్ధిర్బలం యశో ధైర్యం నిర్భయత్మరోగత అజాడ్యం వాక్పటుత్వం చ హనుమత్ స్మరణాత్ భవేత్. Everyone who enters the temple is known by the Lord. The CCTV doesn't look at man. It is Krishna who is watching. It is Venkateswara who is watching. And everyone who is entering the temple is being watched by the Lord. And that is why feeling is important. Why are we stressed? Because we have bottled up our feelings. We don't want to show our feelings. Feelings are weakness, that is what people say. I said, no, feelings are not weakness, feelings are strength. To feel is to be human and humane. First thing we have to be is human. What is man made of man, says a poet. How we have become mechanized, digital, so digital. A funeral is passing by, we are playing with our mobile. SMS, can't you say Narayana 1 minute? Can't you say Govinda for that person who's passed away? Can't you halt for a while? Must your entertainment go on when somebody has ended his life? Heartless we are. My grandfather, who lived in British times, used to say, we didn't like the British prema, that is true. But if there was a funeral passing by, the British gentleman would get down from the carriage, take off his cap, salute the funeral, and then go. Clap for him. This is the last homage we paid. Heartless we have become. Heartless we have become. What has happened to us? What has education done? What is the need for degrees and degrees and degrees if you don't have a degree of humanity in you? What is the use? Here was an incident which moved us to tears. The Lord calls Uddhava. Vrishnenam pravaro mantri krishnasya detasakha shishyo brahaspate sakshat uddhavo buddhi sattamaha. I heard there are professional biodata writers, resume writers. You give them 10,000 rupees, they'll write a nice resume. You give them 20, they'll write more about you. All that you are not. Have I not told you that a resume is an exaggerated version of what you do, what is non-existent talent? Here was a real, real resume. What was it? Pravaro Mantri, Krishnasya Vaita Sakha, Shishyo Brihaspate Sakshat, Uddhavo Buddhi Sattamaha, rank holder, Brihaspati Shishya. Brihaspati Jupiter is the preceptor of gods and he studied under him, not correspondence course. The Lord finds that he is becoming proud. When you learn it, you are proud. You have a sneer. You look down upon those who are not well read. Scholarship sometimes boosts your ego. That is one thing I did not find in my master Dikshitar and in my master Akhandananji. Stupendous scholarship. Any shloka from Mahabharata, Ramayana, Gita, Upanishad, anything you could ask him. Offhand, not saying I'll clear your doubt tomorrow. No. Krishna is calling Uddhava. Go Uddhava, where Swami? Go to Vrindavan. To meet your parents? Yes, Uddhava. And to meet the gopis? Oh, you mean cowherd women? You don't know them. Uddhava, you don't know them. They live by me, I live in them. They live for me, I live for them. Ta, man manaska, mat prana, madarthe tyakta dehika, mameva daitam paishtam, atmanam manasagataha. They have reached with their hearts, they have reached me. Well, if you want me to meet the uneducated women of Vrindavan, I will do so, Master. On His Majesty's service, I go. Not very convinced. I always tell my audience, Prince Charles came to Bombay. And Times of India that day published, Prince Charles meet the Dabbawalas of Bombay. At least today the Dabbawalas have the name written. Those days there were more names. The vegetarian Dabba went to the vegetarian, the non-vegetarian to the non-vegetarian. How he remembered the Dabbas, we don't know. Prince Charles was zapped. That means if you want to know a country, go to the grassroots level.
Learn from people in the grassroots level. One day, as we were driving towards Tirupati, there was a farmer who was collecting groundnuts. We who are from cities have never seen fresh groundnut. We always go to a supermarket and buy a packet of, God knows when it was packed. Although there is a date mentioned, I don't believe the date. I have my own doubts. Fresh groundnuts. I told Ramu, I want groundnuts. I want groundnuts with a child's delight. That fellow brought me so much. And I said, how much do I pay? Paisa, he said. I felt ashamed of myself. You understand? I hope you understand. I said, sorry. Thank you, Anna. I said, thank you. You understand what grassroots is? That is Bharat. That is Bharat, my dear listener. That is Bharat. Five-star hotel, not Bharat. The so-called modern Bharat is not Bharat. That unspoilt villager is Bharat. Where he gives without asking. Where he gives more than asking. That is the farmer who is working in the field and giving us our daily bread. I want you to understand why Krishna wants him to go to the cowardices of Vrindavan. And when he goes there, the Bhagavata says, he meets the father and mother. Mother is in tears. Ever since the Lord left, she sits like a stone, petrified, not knowing what has happened. Sometimes you are so shocked that you don't even wink. She's sitting there, and here is Nand Baba saying, look at her. Ever since Krishna went away, she is like patience on a monument, sitting there, pining away for him. When will he come back? How is he, sir? How is your Krishna? Our Krishna? You? No, sir. He is your Krishna now. He is no more our Krishna because we are ordinary people. He has reached high places. He has reached high places. He is a politician now. He is a kingmaker. He must have forgotten the humble beginnings where he was. Does he remember us, sir? Does he remember? What do you say, Nand Baba? He sent me for you. Next morning, early morning, you have Uddhava going over to the gate. And beyond the gate, is the golden chariot which Krishna gave him, his chariot, to use. Around the chariot he finds beautiful women, all the gopis. I call them beautiful terrorists. They are looking at the chariot. Whose chariot is this? Oh, a fellow called Uddhava has come from Mathura. Who is he? He is Prime Minister. Vishrinam Pravaro Mantri Krishnasya Deita Sakha Shishyo Brihaspati Saksha Uddhavu Buddhi Sattamaha. Why do these plunderers come from Mathura to Vrindavan? What have they to loot here? After a fellow called Akrura came and took away our Lord, send the urban plunderers back. For the first time, Uddhava is nervous. You don't say, my heart is not working. You always say, the head is not working. The head has come to halt. What are they saying? What are they saying, these women? Oh, look there. That is the Prime Minister. He's got a tilakam just like Krishna. He's wearing a uttariyam which I embroidered for Krishna. Of the two bangles, I gave one to Krishna, says another gopi. During the Rasa Leela, the Lord stole my long earring. He is wearing it. Oh, if he was Krishna, he wouldn't stand far away. He would come and hug us. This is some fellow in a fancy dress. Bairupiya hai. There is a gopi whom they make as leader gopi. Have I not told you before, my audience? The emanation of excellence amidst mediocrity is leadership. When everybody is mediocre and one person is excellent, you make him the leader. Leader gopi, talk to him. He's very clever. Must have gone to law school. Because you can't speak. You can't speak what you want to the Prime Minister. The TV will record it and there will be defamation suit. Gopi says, how do I? I want to abuse him. There are moments when you want to abuse the Lord. May I tell you? You shout at your husband, he won't come back from the club. You shout at your wife, she'll go away with her friends.
You shout at children, they won't come back for the vacation. You shout at Narayana, he'll call you to Tirupati at once.
Gussa karo usse nirbhayi pritam. Hard-hearted God, I call.
He listens. You know why? Because only those whom you love, you can abuse. I always shout at him in English. English is a lovely language, abusing. Strong language, strong language. Now the gopi finds a bee comes hovering. And she looks at the bee. Let me shout at the bee. In case some Supreme Court lawyer files a court again, case against me and says, you abused the Prime Minister. I said, no sir, I abused the bee. If the cap fits the Prime Minister, let him wear it. That is how I'll be out. Out, not guilty. You understand? Very clever gopi. My dear listeners, the style of the Bhagavata and the style of the Ramayana are totally different from each other. Valmiki Ramayana is like flowing Ganges. Tapasvadhyay niratam tapasvivak vidambaram naradam paribaprachya Valmiki Munipungamam. In the voice of my master Dikshitar, tapasvadhyay niratam tapasvi vagvidambaram naradam paripapraksha valmikir munipungavam konvasmin sampratam loke gunavan kascha viryavan dharmajnyascha kratajnyascha satyavakyu dhrudavrataha guruvayrappa. He would call out to all of us would learn. Even without learning Sanskrit, you will learn Ramayana. Simple language. How is the style of the Bhagavata? Yam pravrajantam anupetam apetakrityam vaipayano virahgatara juhava putreti tanmayataya taravo viridu tam sarvabhutarudayam munimanatosmi. This is how the gopi is speaking. First, let me summarize to you what the verse mean and then read out the difficult verse to you. You be. You messenger, fraudulent messenger of a fraudulent master, fraudulent messenger of a fraudulent master, go away. On your mouth I find saffron. From where? Saffron from the tip of the flowers which are crushed in the garlands during the embrace of my lord and his new girlfriends. What meticulous jealousy. Only women can be jealous. Please clap for us. It's a privilege to be jealous because we love the Lord. We love our husband. We love the Lord. We love the husband. Here it's the Lord. Madhupakita vabandhu mas prishangrin sapatnya kucha vilmitam mala kumkumashmashubitnaha vahatu madhupatistan manini nam prasadam yadu sadasi vidambyam yasya dutatvamidrika. Yasya dutatvamidrika. Universal complaint. Every husband who goes on a business trip does not make a phone call. The poor woman is sitting with a mobile. The mobile is a boon and a bane together. Oh, finally he calls. And when he calls, the lady is angry. Band karo. I won't talk to him. 3 days he has not called. After switching off the phone, she's looking at it. Will it ring again? Will Krishna remember us? Does he remember us, Uddhava? Uddhava, Uddhava. Does he remember Vrindavan? Does he remember the Rasa Leela? Please tell us, Uddhava Bhai. Please tell us. Apivata Madhupuriyam Arya Putro Dhunaste Smalati Sipitrigehan Saumya Bandhum Chagopan Kvachitapi Sakathana Kinkarinam Grinite Bhujam Aguru Sugandham Murdni Adastyat Kadanu. When will he come back, Uddhava? When will he come back? When will we get his ashraya, shelter under his care? And as Uddhava listens to this plaintive appeal of the gopis, he collapses. All the ego of the head is gone. The heart is working now. The heart is full of praise. When the heart takes over, there is humility.
When the head takes over, there is pride. When the heart takes over, you are important. When the head takes over, I am important. When the heart takes over, we know our faults. When the head takes over, we realize other people's faults. When the heart takes over, you forgive. When the head takes over, you take revenge. Now, Uddhava is humbled. He is on the ground, Sashtanga Namaskara. He is on the ground, prostrating before the gopis. Wonderful women, thrice wonderful women. Now I know why the Lord sent me here. What a way you love the Lord. Aho yuyam sma purunartha bhavatya loka pujita. You are the talk of the world. The entire world is praising you for your extraordinary bhakti, your unique love of the Lord. Vasudevi bhagavati yasam ityarpitam manaha. When you can't express, you say like this. Like this means inexpressible. He is awesome, his bhaktas are awesome. His bhaktas are also awesome. You can't explain. Can you explain? Can you analyze who is Narayana Bhattagiri? Can you analyze Meera? Can you analyze Tyagaraja? Can you analyze Kabira? No. And Amacharya? No. They are awesome people. Adbhuta people. The Lord is now making Uddhava say, How did you get this bhakti? I'm asking all of you. I don't know your bank balance, sir. Your auditor must be knowing it. But I know what your spiritual bank balance is. I know that you are there listening to the Bhagavatam because in several janmas you have done dana, vrata, tapa, homa, japa, svadhyaya, samyama, and you have Krishna bhakti. That Krishna bhakti has brought you here. And that too, listening to Bhagavad Gita in Tirumala. One more clap for yourself. Self-esteem. My master used to say, there are some religions who say we are sinners. No. When the Narayaniyam starts, it's Hanta Bhagyam Jananaham. We are lucky people. Unless we are lucky, we can't be here. So clap for ourselves. Hanta Bhagyam Jananaham. Dana, Vrata, Tapa, Homa, Japa, Svadhyaya, Samyamaihi. After several births of several sadhanas, you become a Krishna Bhakta. Have I not told you? Krishna Bhakti is not spasmodic, not sporadic, not impulsive, not coming, not going. It is the collective penance down the ages. Several births you have done sadhana. And they are being praised by Uddhava. Dishtya putran patin dehan swajanan bhavanani chan. You have given up everything and come to Krishna. Pati sutan vaya Krishna bratra bandhavan ati vilanjate Krishna tyachyuta agatam gati nirastavot Krishna gita mohitam kitavayoshita Krishna kastya jinnishi. We have given up everything. How can you give up? How can you give up the gopis? This is what you said. That's why he came. Kesha Pashadrita Pinchika Vitati Sanchalan Makara Kundalam. Because of your sacrifice he came. I tell children, you don't grow by what you have. You grow by what you can give up. Your dispossession, you grow. The Lord is happy with our sacrifices rather than with our accumulation. The Lord is now making us understand how the gopis gave up everything to come to the Lord. I admire you, men and women in the modern world, giving up all your time which you gave for the office and for your family, and you are here. Clap for yourself. This is tapasya. This is yoga. Uddhava came with a transit visa. He extended the visa. Continued to stay in Vrindavan. Why? Because I said he got a degree from Brihaspati Acharya, but he wanted a doctorate from Vrindavan. And the gopis are the guides. The gopis are the guides. He had to get his doctorate under the gopis. So next morning, what is the alarm? Govinda Dhamo Dharma. Oh, the gopis are up. The gopis are churning butter. I must get them quickly. He has a bath. He puts tilakam, lovely clothes, and goes and sits next to a gopi. Gopi, gopi, please tell me something about Krishna. Oh, that's what I do day and night. Sit. Sit and listen. Tell me something, gopi. Tell me something. Oh, yes, sir. One day he was small little child and he's asking his mother, for what? For a bowl. What for? She said, I want to drink milk. There's no milk now. When will you milk the cow? At night. What is night? Oh God. You wait for your child to talk and then you would wait for a child to stop talking. How many questions the child will ask? As if the mother is an encyclopedia, kaun banega karodpati. How many questions can she answer? What is night? Let me think, Krishna. Think, mother. Think, because I am thought. Sarvasya chaham hridi sannivishto matya smriti jnanam apunam. Krishna? Yes. Ma? Night is the setting of darkness. Krishna is silent. Krishna? Krishna? What's the problem? Mother, night has set in. He shuts his eyes and says, night has set in, darkness. It's not a joke. It's a philosophic concept that he is making clear. His mother thinks that he is a little boy. But we know he is Narayana. On the battlefield, something happens to the Mahabharata. I'm very fond of the Mahabharata because it shakes you up. It is life. Not a slice of life, but life itself. All the gruesome details of violence and passion, hatred and love, above all, overpowering devotion of the Pandavas for Krishna. And Krishna's overpowering love for the Pandavas. Something that makes me jealous day in and day out. One day, Krishna takes Arjuna far away. And when Arjuna comes back, there's a grim silence in the tent. What happened? Why are you silent? Why are you silent? He's asking his brothers. Nobody answers. Where is he? Where is my son, Abhimanyu? Who killed him? I don't find him here. Every time I come back from the battlefield, he says, well done, father, well done. How well you fought, my father. How well you fought. Where is he? Who killed him? Jayadratha stopped the way and we could not help him. That is the confession. I will kill Jayadratha by tomorrow evening. This is what Arjuna says. Without telling Krishna, he has made the vow. Otherwise, I will die. The next day, the sun is setting. I hope you know who Jayadratha is. Jayadratha is the wonderful brother-in-law of Duryodhana. He is married to the only sister, Dushala. And what is the qualification of Jayadratha? He doesn't spare a single sin. Do you know that he tries to misbehave with Draupadi? And Draupadi says, you fool, you are the son-in-law of the family, I am the daughter-in-law of the family. Is this the way you misbehave with me? But he has no qualms, no conscience at all. Duryodhana protects him from morning till evening. The Lord says, what happened, Arjuna? Swami, I took a vow that I will die by this evening if I don't kill Jayadratha. The Lord says, die. Everybody who is born has to die. Jatasya hi dhruvo mrityu, dhruvam janma mrityasya cha. Don't quote the Gita now, Krishna. I am not in the mood to listen to the Gita. I want help from you. Don't worry, Arjuna. I will light the fire for you. And you go around the fire, have my darshan and go to moksha. No, Krishna. I don't want moksha now. I want to take revenge as a kshatriya father. The Lord says, I will create an artificial night. And when the night is created, this man called Jayadratha will peep out of his hiding. And he does so. And as he comes out, the Lord says, shoot at his head. His father has taken a vow. He who makes the head of my son fall will have his head cut off. So see that both father and son die together. His father is doing vandana. Go and see that the son's head goes and falls into the hand of the father. That is how the Lord on the battlefield of the Mahabharata makes day into night and night into day, my dear listeners. That is what he can do. That Lord is asking for a cup of milk, says the gopi.